Hello, everyone. My name is Aaron Standard, and I'm the founder and CEO of Petabridge, a company that helps .NET enterprises build large-scale distributed systems using open-source technologies like Akka.NET. And today, I want to talk about distributed tracing, an emerging DevOps practice that our customers are using to help make it easier to debug, develop, and deploy distributed and concurrent systems. So first, let's start with why we need distributed tracing. Historically, we've developed our applications in the past as monoliths, where all of the code was hosted inside a single process and was written using a single implementation language, usually. This made it really easy for us to understand what might be going on at runtime inside this application. We could attach a step 3 debugger to our app, or we could use a really good tracing tool like IntelliTrace to capture lots of data about what was happening at runtime, because everything all happened inside a single process. However, as the internet became a bigger place and our applications needed to grow in scale and complexity in order to meet all of the demands and expectations of our customers, architects realized that we needed to have an approach where we could break up and decompose monoliths into small interdependent services. And this is where microservice architectures really started to take off. Microservice architectures are really about scaling people, not products. What they allow for technical leaders to do is partition their organization along the boundaries of their services. So, for instance, I can have one service implemented using one set of tools that are the best for that job, and another service implemented using a totally different set of tools. And those two services can interoperate with each other because they all work using explicit network communication contracts, such as an HTTP API or maybe actor messaging or something else like that. And so what this allows teams to do is still build a networked application that can accomplish the big goals our organizations have, but we can deploy and update and develop each of those individual components independently of the others. And so these microservice architectures really allow our software organizations to be more agile and to deliver product faster to our customers. But they aren't without their costs. In a monolithic application, your monitoring and tracing infrastructure only needs to tell the story of how your software ran from the perspective of a single process. All the data on why a particular request succeeded or failed is all right there. It's really easy to get access to that data and use it to tell a story using tracing tools like IntelliTrace. In microservices, however, this is no longer true. The first big problem that we have is a loss of coherence, where when one service makes a request to another, and maybe that service makes a request to another service downstream, it becomes very difficult for us to trace where exactly did a particular request fail, or even what happened in the course of processing this successful request. And this loss of coherence makes it really difficult to explain what's going on inside your application. And it makes it more difficult to onboard new people. And it also makes it much more difficult to debug problems that occur in production with microservices. So for instance, errors can happen in one downstream service or multiple downstream services at the exact same time. And a lot of the error details that we would normally be able to capture from just a simple stack trace in a monolith may not be propagated back. And these errors might also occur in potentially totally different runtimes. A .NET microservice might fail when a Ruby microservice throws an exception and returns a failed status code back. And it can be very difficult to go and track down where exactly the problem begins and whose responsibility it is to fix it. And this becomes a communication and a cross-teaming problem, where in essence, without having some standardized way of being able to get data from each of the processes that participated in a given transaction, it can be really hard to figure out what went wrong and how to fix it. And then there's also the information silos that form as a result of the independence of all these teams. The very thing that made it so easy for us to deploy and develop software is also what makes it harder to debug and diagnose it. So, in the grand scheme of things, what microservices can really do is end up creating communication problems for you and your team that make it more expensive and more difficult to turn around fixes and solutions to your problems. What distributed tracing can do is distributed tracing offers a tool to solve these communication problems and restore coherence inside your distributed system. This is where distributed tracing comes into play. It's an entirely new type of DevOps tool designed exclusively for use with distributed systems, such as microservice architectures. The basic idea behind distributed tracing is simple. Take something that worked really well for single monolithic processes and adapt it to work well for multiple distributed processes. We accomplish this by capturing the context from each individual operation inside each service, and then we propagate that information downstream to the next microservice that's processing the next call in the call chain. This allows us to capture detailed per-operation data, such as log messages, or information about the current request, or we can even tag each of the individual operations to make them easy to search and find inside a reporting system later. And on top of that, all of our distributed tracing engines that we're going to talk about today support out-of-band reporting, meaning that none of the work the distributed tracing system does will interfere with the execution of your application. All of the uploading and reporting of these span data will be done asynchronously. And all of these tools, these distributed tracing engines, feature really rich visualization and diagnostic tools designed to allow you to go ahead and see the entire chain of events that occurred inside your distributed system. This is designed to help restore coherence. And on top of that, many of these engines also support the ability to drill down into individual operations and the ability to search for specific requests with things like specific status codes or maybe requests that all pertain to the same session ID. All this sort of data is designed to make it much easier to understand what's happening inside a microservice network or any other type of distributed architecture. Distributed tracing systems work by correlating trace and span ID numbers across each successive request inside a networked system. A trace refers to an end-to-end distributed operation. So when an end user makes a request to service 1, that initiates a brand new trace. And a span refers to a single local operation inside one or more services. In the case of service 3, we have one span representing our database query, that's span number 4, and once this span completes, span number 3, which represents the HTTP request sent to service 3 originally, that span will be reported as completed once we begin serving our HTTP response back to service 2. And from there, service 2's span will complete, and then service 1's. And this will be the entire end result of this particular request from this end user. And a distributed tracing system, such as Zipkin in this instance, might visualize that data a little bit like this. This is a histogram output, and it can show you how long each step of this operation took. So 40 milliseconds for a database query, 140 milliseconds for an HTTP request to service number 3, and so forth. And we can see the rough call chain and the start times. And most tracing systems will let you drill into each one of these operations and get a load of the data that's occurring inside each one of those processes. Ultimately, though, the most powerful feature of distributed tracing is the fact that it can work transparently across all of these different programming languages and frameworks. Most of the major distributed tracing engines have drivers that support Ruby and .NET and Node.js and Java. And all of that data can still be combined back together into a single histogram, just like this one on screen. So that's something that we can do to go ahead and restore some of the coherence and the debuggability of our systems. And that's why we should talk a little bit about the benefits of distributed tracing. The first big benefit of distributed tracing is that it radically improves developer productivity and output. And distributed tracing accomplishes this by making it easy to understand the behavior of distributed systems. And this helps drastically reduce debugging and diagnostic time by being able to go and see where an error actually occurred and at what stage during the microservice request chain that happened. It makes it a lot easier to figure out where to start when it comes time to debug and fix an error that may have occurred inside your application. And on top of that, it's actually quite easy to set up and instrument distributed tracing too. Most frameworks like Ruby on Rails or ASP.NET Core ship with little plugins you can use that will automatically just snap in distributed tracing support. And we'll talk about OpenTracing in a moment here, which is a standard you can use to make this even easier to set up and use. The next big benefit of distributed tracing is that it works across multiple applications and transports. So a Ruby on Rails application can propagate tracing data to a .NET Core application over an HTTP API, or maybe RabbitMQ, or maybe something like SignalR, or even Okta.NET Actors. And even though we might be using these different transports or these different programming languages or different web frameworks, all of the information that's being gathered from each one of these processes can still be uploaded and rendered together into one contiguous trace inside a tool like Zipkin or Jaeger, some of the distributed tracing engines that we're going to be introducing in a second. So this will help us eliminate black holes and information silos inside our microservice applications. And all of this is designed to help improve time to market. We can go and deploy or upgrade existing services and immediately visualize the impact they have on the system. If something goes wrong during a deployment, we can go ahead and track down exactly which types of requests with which pieces of metadata were causing failures in the new version of our application. This will help improve our team's agility and ultimately help improve the bottom line too. The last big benefit of distributed tracing is that it makes it possible for teams that are working on multiple parts of your product, multiple different services or multiple different sets of services, to all cooperate together and work effectively on solving problems. And this is because end user activities can be traced end to end inside your system with a distributed tracing tool. So this will help teams communicate more effectively and understand where they should put their time and resources when it comes time to debug issues with microservices or when it comes time to figure out how to implement a feature. Distributed tracing will help visualize the results for every member of your organization, and this will have a huge impact on developer productivity and time to market. So for some examples of some popular tracing engines. So I've got some logos here from a couple different open source projects. So there's Jaeger, which was originally developed in-house by Uber. That's open source. And then Zipkin, which was originally developed by Twitter for keeping track of all their microservice calls. But then there's also tools like Datadog APM, which are proprietary, but they'll still provide a really similar experience to what these open source tools can do, and they might have some additional features and support that the open source technologies can't get. So there's lots of different tools available, and there's more and more entering the space all the time. But what we're recommending to our customers is to look for distributed tracing tools that implement the OpenTracing standard. This is a vendor-neutral standard for facilitating distributed tracing, and it's a standard that a lot of library authors, such as Pettibridge, are targeting in order to make sure that we can support a wide range of tracing tools without having to go and have any vendor-specific support for any of them. So if you go ahead and adopt a tool like Zipkin or Jaeger, which supports OpenTracing, you can go ahead and immediately use the OpenTracing support that's built into Node.js or Ruby on Rails or ASP.NET Core and get up and running much more quickly and make it even easier to instrument your applications. So that's something that we recommend starting with. Now, thanks for watching, and if you're interested in learning a little bit more about distributed tracing, we recommend taking a look at the following links on the screen, and we'll also include them in the body down below. And thanks for watching.